As the days passed, everyone in the village believed that Tom and Becky had been lost and died. Few men continued their search in the cave. A funeral for them was held in the church. Miss Thatcher became very ill. She would wake in the middle of the night calling for Becky, and no one could help her. Aunt Polly was so sad that she couldn't speak. Her gray hair changed from gray to white. One night, the church bells began ringing. People ran through the street shouting, "They are found! They've been found!" Everybody ran down to the river where Becky and Tom were being carried from a boat. They were brought to the Thatcher's house with the whole village following, shouting for joy. Aunt Polly's happiness was complete. Miss Thatcher's happiness would be complete when the news reached her husband. He was still in the cave continuing the search. Tom lay in bed telling the story of his frightening adventure. They had gone out in one direction as far as the length of the string. Then he tried another opening. The third time, he thought he could see a light. He went as far as the string would take him, then dropped it and went toward the light. It was a small hole in the rock. When he put his head out through the small hole, he could see the river on which the boat had brought them to the picnic. He told everyone how he ran back to get Becky. At first, she did not believe him. She just wanted to stay there and die. After a while, she followed Tom. When she saw the sunlight, she almost died of joy. He helped her walk to the opening, climbed through it himself, and helped her through. They walked down to the river and found a boat with some men in it. The men couldn't believe Tom's wild story. After all, the children were 5 miles south of the door of the cave. The men took them to a house near the river and gave them something to eat before bringing them back to the village. It was several days before they were strong again. Tom learned about Huck's illness and went to visit him, but Miss Douglas wouldn't let the boys talk about their adventures. Tom learned about what had happened at Cardiff Hill at home. He also heard that the strange man had been found in the river. He had drowned while trying to escape. About 2 weeks later, Tom went to visit Becky at the Thatcher's house. Judge Thatcher and some of his friends were there. "Well, Tom," Judge Thatcher said, "would you like to go into the cave again?" Tom said yes. "I thought so," the judge said. "So I had the door covered with iron, and it is locked. No one can open it. No one will ever get lost in the cave again." Tom's face turned white. "What's wrong?" the judge asked. "Oh, Judge Thatcher," Tom said, "Indian Joe is in the cave."